nitrous tank is gone. Remember, nitrous only goes up to 650 psi. We've ditched that. We've got high pressure oxygen and a high pressure regulator now, so we can effectively put much more pressure in. There's a lot gone off. I was able to work out exactly what pressure we ignited that rocket at last time out, and it was about 280 psi of nitrous. This time we've set the minimum level to 600. So we'll be testing now at 600 psi. First time ever I've been able to do a test here at high pressure, because I've used the manifold to pressurize up with high pressure oxygen gas. It was calibrated using the air compressor, which only went up to 150 psi. And then after that, it became very inaccurate. Now I've been able to use the actual high pressure oxygen in the manifold and take readings with my computers, exactly what is being recorded, and it was way out. So now I've fine-tuned it, I've recalibrated it, and now, interestingly, from when we built a single chamber rocket, I can tell you how much thrust was developed, and it was just short of 120 kg, just there. And these are the gas pressures. So we tested at about 650 before we achieved that. And now our minimum is, well, I'm gonna do it at 600, because it's its first maiden voyage at these pressures. But we can go from 600 to 1,000. And that thrust will go way up. So I'm anticipating about 350 kg of thrust from that. And I think we can take that to nearly half a ton of thrust. And because of this extra thrust, I've strengthened it. So what I've built are these units here and here. So we're no longer just relying on the bearings wrapped around this V. We've got these front and back encapsulating the whole rocket on the moving track. There is also, this is a 500 kg load cell. When we start moving the pressures up towards 1000 psi, if that snaps, it will be caught by these reinforcers and these, so it won't go anywhere. This is also new. This is our new cooling system. PSI over 4 jets. Feel how cold that is.
Down here.
That is going to cool those chambers.
Yeah,
totally cool those chambers.
Gosh, yeah, that's amazing. And the glass.
System, because we had a big hole burnout there. Very, very cold CO2 onto these chambers. That will stop it overheating. It's all been made. Also, this is new. Got a new box. It's all been foam padded out. We have two USB connectors running on the two Arduinos, and they will give us, which we've never had before, live stream data of thrust and the gas pressures from chambers, from oxygen, carbon dioxide cylinders, and from storage gas chambers. And I'll have a GoPro on here live filming that. And also we've got the SD cards working as well. So we'll have masses of information, which is really important. Oh, we should get three times. So that's why I'm predicting around 350 kg of thrust. Then when I, the next time I come out, I'll increase the pressure, always going up to 1000 psi, and that thrust will get greater and greater and greater. So I believe I can get nearly half a ton of thrust out of this, but we'll start with 350 kg of thrust, which will be, believe you me, pretty awesome. The cooling system that's going to stop it burning out works off this system that Dangerous Dave made.
For CO2.
Yeah.
Number two button can go for fire.
Yeah.
Number three button can be for ops.
And
so this is the system that was started for the fire extinguisher. Yeah.
So it now controls this automatic fire extinguisher here. So if we're 100 meters away and we have a catastrophic event, we can radio control this to fill the whole area with powdered CO2 and dampen everything down. Open and close. So this opens the CO2 cooling system, and that closes it. And to start it, what you have to do, you've got to first tune it in 200 meters away, and it works beautifully. So this can be, I don't know, system straight away because it's not needed. So I'm guessing 2 seconds into maximum thrust, open up the CO2 and start cooling that down. I've calibrated them, which I've never been able to do before, and they're absolutely accurate. So these will gradually be illuminated as the oxygen builds up in these chambers. And because of the diameter of these chambers, we tested these to about 1300 psi underwater in the swimming pool. Very first job is the high pressure oxygen bottle is open right now, and it takes 8 seconds for the valve to open. It's indicated with that vertical white lines, the valve is open. This signal is a true signal of valve position. It's working off a micro switch on the valve. Throttle is now off. Firstly, I've made a continuous carbon fiber tube pump. These are made with 100% ABS plastic, 3D printed. This is made and it's got to be stronger than these, is continuous carbon fiber. So that's what's inside. It's a matrix of continuous carbon fiber layers built up.